Kristen Jen Johnson. Welcome to the show, Rome Sausage.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good to see you guys. Local ingredients.
Yeah.
It's kind of fun. You fixing the microphone for her?
I am.
Bringing it up there so she doesn't want to be on the mic. Is that what I'm seeing?
She's really.
Why?
I'm just not a radio girl.
Well, I mean. Well,
yeah, here's an easy question. You like tequila?
I love tequila.
There we go. You're a radio gal. Right there.
Easy.
That was easy.
She's got a face for TV, and I'm more a radio guy, so it's a nice kind of symbiotic.
Mix. Yeah.
It's good team.
Balance things out.
Yeah.
Well, Kevin, where do you start, Chef, with sourcing ingredients?
I think it all starts with the conception of the dish. You know, you start with what is going on in the dish,
sure.
and then from there you build up. You start with the bottom and build up. We started with the tortillas, and we've researched a lot of companies. We met Little Rich,
mm-hmm.
been with him from day one, and haven't changed.
Yeah.
And then from there it's just whatever you're doing. Is it a cheese? Is it a protein? Is it a vegetable? And then you just kind of figure out what season, you know, obviously you know what season
right.
you're in, but then you kind of assemble the dish from there.
And relationships are a lot, too.
Relationships are huge, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. We've been with vendors.
Years
and
years.
I mean, I've been self-employed for 20 years. I work with some of the same vendors.
Exactly.
So that's nice.
It's great to hear.
So
yeah.
when really and thank you, because we said, Rome Sausage is going to be in the house tonight. Hey, Chef, do you mind doing this? And it's kind of a funky little thing, because it's like, all right, I already use sausage
yeah.
from somebody else.
But I'm glad Chris is here today because, you know, he's opening my eyes to some new stuff and gives me some new ideas. So
great point,
awesome.
Because I wanted to actually expound upon that. So a lot of times you're in your own little bubble.
Yeah, it's
you
easy
know?
To get tunnel vision.
Sure.
And that's why you have to get out and, you know, the internet makes it easy to research new products now.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you can go anywhere in the world that's sitting at your desk or in your bed or wherever. But traveling, nothing's like being there and touching it and feeling it and eating it.
Truly.
But, yeah, it's just trying new products.
Yeah.
And then from then, it just sparks your innovation.
Yeah, Chris, what do you do with that? You know, you've got your relationships with folks, obviously,
right.
all over the place, but cultivating new relationships. Kind of cool to talk to Kevin tonight and
Absolutely,
maybe have the opportunity.
Man. I mean, you know, it makes my heart feel good because we're producing soulful, you know, straightforward, you know, products in the small batch scenario. And it's nice to find guys who appreciate that. And, you know, I think we're a company that's set up in a way that we need to, you know, reach chefs, you know, bring items to them and go, hey, look, this isn't the normal stuff. This isn't the normal, like, run-of-the-mill, mass-produced stuff. We're making great stuff here. It fits what you're doing. Let's move forward kind
yeah.
of thing.
So, talk about it.
Yeah.
And so you do that a lot. And I said Mrs. Sausage tonight. She's like, do I hit him or do I embrace that? You're Mr. Sausage.
Yeah.
You guys live this. This is your life.
Right.
You love this type of
right.
thing. This was perfect for me. Good taste. I'd be interested to taste the original, I guess, I would say.
This is really good.
Is it really good?
Yeah, that's why we're talking after the show. This is really good.
And is that really what it comes down to? Because a lot of times, regardless of relationships and accessibility, which are big a lot of times, sometimes you just go, I can't be without that. That's pretty good.
Yeah, sometimes when you get introduced to a product, you fall in love with it, and your imagination just takes off. And you're like, I got to work with that product or that company.
Mm-hmm. What's new with you?
We've been swamped, man. And I was telling Rich on the break that we've seen a lot of folks come to us and say, hey, we want you to produce our meatball or our sausage or this or that because we're having a hard time getting consistent product out and worried about the minimum wage increase. And we got to find somebody who can make this consistently in the same kind of hands-on, small batch, quality-centered scenario that we do. So that's been a blessing for us as far as that business coming our way. So.
And your offerings are vast.
Yeah, I mean, we always say yes when the phone rings.
What type of things are you selling right now?
We're doing a hand-rolled meatball for an Italian chain here. It's got 5 stores. And the founder of the company told me the other day, older guy, he shook my hand. He's like, hey, man, you saved my business. I'm like, well, that's high praise, but thank you. It's just a meatball, you know. We're doing some custom Italian sausage, and we're going to do a burger blend for a quick-moving burger concept. So we're rocking and rolling, man.
Building new relationships.
Mm-hmm.
I know Aspen Baking's a new relationship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we do a little bit with those guys. They're doing some catering. They have a catering division, so we do some patties for the folks over at Aspen. So
yeah.
Good people.
Kevin, what are you looking for? What would you like to find? Is there anything out there?
I'd love to find something that no one else has.
Yeah. Which is there anything?
I don't think there's – no, there's not
nothing.
Anything.
Did you know this was going to be a sales call live on the air?
I did. That's awesome.
Not as far as sausage goes, but just anything ingredient in general.
Well, you know, something's interesting, and we've got to go to break here, but what's interesting is how do we – process the foods. The other day I was looking at something and somebody froze something before they gave it to me.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, what if you did that on purpose? As opposed to, because, you know, sometimes you can freeze a tomato or something like that.
Right.
Peel the skin or something. You know, but there's different things, and that's where I wonder if something's going to come new out of that because of the way we handle it or some post-harvest processing.
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm sure there are. I mean, there's so many chefs out there that really push the edge, especially with, what is it called? Cooking with chemicals where they freeze things.
Hold that thought.